Hey, it's SGU, and we are back for more Saquon Barkley Career Mode Series here in Madden 19. It is week four, and it's going to be a matchup against the New Orleans Saints. You see Saquon Barkley doing well for himself in the statistical categories, but what can he do today here at home against New Orleans?
It's the coach, and you're watching Madden 19 on EA Sports. Coming up, 2017 Offensive Rookie of the Year, Alvin Kamara. Fresh off a big performance a week ago. Coming up, we'll see the visiting New Orleans Saints taking on the New York Giants. I'll be back with you again with scores around the league at halftime. But kickoff right around the corner. And standing by to call the action, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, we welcome everybody to the Garden State. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the sight of their men in blue emerging from the MetLife tunnels. We're set to go as the Giants get ready to match up with Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you take a look at this Giants ball club. Now, losers their last time out, so they'll look to make amends here.
And one of the best ways you can do that is to be at home, and they are.
So the Giants looking to turn around a kind of disappointing 1-2 start to the season. Of course, in real life, they're, what, 1-6 right now? Obviously hoping to do better than that. Saquon's going to catch a ball to start this game from Eli Manning out of the backfield, and it's going to be a gain of 8. 2nd and 2, and he's pitching to the right. And we got a juke, and we got a block out front, and we got some open room down the sideline, and a juke leaves the defender in the dust. Saquon could go all the way, and he will. Long touchdown for the rookie. Now that's how you want to start a game. Giants score the first points of the game via a long touchdown run. And the rookie is feeling it here. Look at the cuts. This is going to be after the big one. And he's pretty much out in the open at this point. Are we going to see another look? You know, just the end of the touchdown run and celebration right there. But boy, oh boy, when he got into open space, he had to make one man miss. And he did exactly that. So will the Saints answer on their first drive? They will not, and they don't even possess the football very long. So it's going to be Giants backed up in their own territory with a 7-0 lead. Saquon pushing on defenders there, getting what he can. He's going to get a gain of about 4. 2nd and 6 now, and it's Eli back to pass. Quick pass, and he's going to get a first down throw over the 20 to the 21-yard line. Giants getting out of the shadow of their own goal line. Saquon Barkley, another handoff, and he's loose again. Outside the 35 to the 37. Oh my. Already approaching 100 yards, 3 carries for 87. That's quite an average right there. Eli's going to drop back to pass. Eli's got a wide open man, and it's a first down pass midfield to the 45 of the Saints. It's Evan Engram making the catch. Giants already with that 7-0 lead. A long drive right here for a score would be mighty impressive. Do they have the first down on 3rd and 4? Yes, they do. A quick hitting pass. And it's 1st and 10. Okay, will they go to the run game? Yes, again, Saquon is not going to go down at first contact. Now, drags a defender for a modest gain of 2 yards. 2nd and 8, and now he's going to split out wide, leaving just the fullback in the backfield. Eli wants to throw quickly, and that play is going to result in another Giants first down. What an impressive drive right now, starting at about their own 10-yard line, and now they're knocking on the door of the red zone. Saquon, again, is going to go in motion, leaving nobody in the backfield. He's going to catch this one over the middle. He's got some room inside the 10. Mark him down at the 6. 1st and goal Giants. Dynamic runner right here. And pass catcher, obviously, as he's pulling double duty there. And looking impressive in both aspects. And looking impressive on his way to the end zone. Not one, but 2 devastating jukes. Oh my, guys looking for their jock straps on the field after this, as you've got some hard cut and juke action from Saquon Barkley. That's just unfair right there. What are defenders supposed to do? Look at the quick footwork. Not one, but 2 defenders left grasping at air as Barkley just pushes his way right on in to the end zone. He has 2 rushing touchdowns, one of the long variety, and 1 knocking on the door of the goal line. New Orleans does come back and get a touchdown. They want to make sure they don't get blown out in this game, making it 14-7. Eli wants to throw on 2nd and 12, and uh-oh, he's going to be picked off deep in Giants territory. And I'll talk about a game swing right there, a momentum swing. It has swung in the favor of New Orleans. They got the 7, and, well, just like that, they score 14 unanswered to tie this game at 14 apiece. We've got 4 minutes and change before halftime, and a very unimpressive run right there for no gain. Second and 10. Will Saquon get the ball again? Yes, he will, and he's not going to have a lot there either. Maybe one or two? Mark him as a gain of 2, and it's 3rd and 8. They got to come up with something right here so they don't have to punt the football. They've already kind of lost the momentum. Here's a little floater out into the flat for Saquon. He makes sure to catch that one. Falls for a first down, and the Giants needed that one, if nothing else, just to stall out with the ball a little bit here and not give it right back to Drew Brees. Here's a nice pass. That one's wide open and is going to get them out close to midfield now. Maybe they're thinking points before halftime as you see play action and a little bit of a roll. A throw to the far side right there. Catch is made. We got an injury to Cameron Jordan of the Saints, but you've got a Giants first down. Now at the 34-yard line, 1st and 10. Can they punch it in once again before halftime? Saquon's going to be ripped down right there, but he does get a gain of about 4 yards. 2nd and 6 turns into 3rd and 6. 2-minute warning, 1:57 to play now. Deadlocked at 14. High snap, but Eli gets it. Brings it down and hands off to Saquon, who gets a decent gain right there, but it's going to be 4th and 1. Timeout for Coach Payton. We must have gone for it because we got it. That's too bad they didn't let us play that out. It went to the simulation. If we're going to go for it, you think they'd put us back on the field for it. Anyway, we got 1st and 10 at the 15, so something went right. And our offense back on the field, at least for us to be able to control now. That's going to be a pass. It's going to get a 1st down and goal, almost a touchdown, all the way to the 1 are the Giants. With about a minute left on the clock to punch this in, they are out of the shotgun, but it's going to be a handoff, and Saquon's in. That's his 3rd score of this first half. This one from just 1 yard out. But the Giants retake the lead with an extra point coming to make it 21-14. You see Saquon with enough momentum to get the ball over the goal line and get his 3rd touchdown of the day. The game now ventures beyond halftime and into the 3rd quarter. And apparently we didn't get that extra point because it's 20-14. That's unfortunate. Must have missed the kick because we didn't go for 2. Saquon running the football right there. Also, it looks like we must have gotten a turnover because we started with a short field in New Orleans territory. And that's going to be a 1st down for the Giants. So new set of downs as the clock continues to run in the 3rd quarter. Not much going on right there for Saquon as he tries to get out to the left. Loss of 1. He is over 100 yards rushing on the day. And this one is a little bit tough mudding to the right side. He gets 1 yard back. 3rd and 10. Can they come up with a pass play here? They do, and it's to Saquon. Inside the 5, puts his shoulder down, muscles to the 3. 1st and goal Giants once again. So this short field starting off their drive has paid off as once again they're knocking on the door. Eli's going to throw, and that's a touchdown, and that's the first non-Saquon Barkley touchdown for the Giants today. It goes to Evan Engram, and all of a sudden they've got their 2-touchdown lead back. Now, will they try to go to 2-point conversion here to get the 14-point lead again? I would assume maybe they would as we watch a couple replays of the Evan Engram touchdown as they mull that decision over. Pylon cam even shows a pretty easy path for Evan Engram into the end zone. They will go for the 2-point conversion. Let's see if they can convert now. Maybe calling an audible at the line. Eli looking through his options. He is going to snap this football, and he's going to throw quickly to Saquon Barkley, who dives for the pylon. He's in for the 2-point conversion. So it is a 14-point lead, 28-14. They led 14-0. Saints roared back and tied it. Now they punch it in 2 more times to reclaim that 14-point lead. Will the Saints come back and get on the board? No. We get the ball back up 28-14. 3rd quarter going our way right now so far. Like to take some of this clock down, though, as we hand off to Saquon Barkley again. Gets 1 yard. 3rd and 9, and Eli needs to throw. Eli's going to find his man. It's Barkley out of the backfield making the catch. He's doing it in that regard as well. 5 catches for 61 yards. Dynamic player. And he is going to run for a first down right there, giving him over 120 yards on 15 carries. Can you stop Saquon Barkley? The answer is no so far for the New Orleans Saints. Here is Eli going to throw as he comes back to the football. He's going to fight for very close to a first down. As a matter of fact, he has it. Great play right there, making something out of nothing, getting open. Second and one later in the drive. He's going to get a first down with a few more juke steps right there. Giants moving the football again. And through three quarters, it's been a successful day for the Giants offense, putting up 28 points thanks to our rookie in no small part. He's going to get a handoff here, and he's almost looks like a horse collar there as he's taken down. It'll be second and eight. Eli Manning to throw. He will throw, and he will get a touchdown. That's going to get all the way in for the score. Who was it this time around? We'll have to look at the replay. It is another toss to Evan. Who is that? That's not Evan Engram. That is Rhett Ellison, the former Minnesota Viking, coming up with the 22-yard reception. And the Giants are rolling right now. They punch it in yet again, not settling for field goals today. And your score is now 35-14 in favor of the hometown Giants. And you got most of a fourth quarter to play here. Again, we made a stop, and again, it looked like we had a short field to start. As we're now down to the 26-yard line, will they punch it in for another score? Can Saquon get loose again? Well, not for a big run, but he does get a first down at the 24-yard line. The Giants just churning this out on the ground and through the short passing game. That's not going to go for very much right there. It'll be second and eight. And you got the fullback in the game blocking. Saquon is going to be taken down by a host of tacklers right there. We're under 5 minutes to play, and he's over 140 yards rushing. Third and eight. What do we have right here? We got play action. Eli wants to throw. Eli's got all sorts of time, but that's going to be knocked away incomplete. So it looks like a field goal attempt coming up here. I don't know if we missed it or just didn't go for it, but the score remains 35-14. And we got the ball back with less than 3 minutes to play now. A pitch. And Saquon, trying to keep his balance, is going to go down. We're nearing the two-minute warning, although we're going to run another play before it. And a stiff arm right there and a minimal gain, closing in on 150 yards. We've also closed in on the two-minute warning, third and seven. Can we maintain the football here? No, that's going to be an incomplete pass, and we're going to have to punt the football away. So the Saints get one more chance. They're going to punch it in for a score, 35-21. Presumably do not get the onside kick here because we get the football at midfield and pretty much just have to run this out. The Saints do have their timeouts left, however, and they choose to use them with just 30 seconds remaining. Second and two. It's going to be a pitch to Saquon. He's going to be ripped down and a loss. Another timeout right here, making it third and seven. And one conversion away from salting away this game for good. How about that? A catch at the sideline. He's not going to go out of bounds. As a matter of fact, he goes for a first down all the way to the 22, and that is going to salt the game away. It's going to be a 35-21 victory for the Giants. They improved to 2-2 on the season now, back to .500 record as they impressively dispatch the New Orleans Saints today. You'll get a chance to peruse the stats here, both passing, receiving, and running. That's three phases of the game, not just two. See Breeze and Manning, how they compare. But we will also see Kamara versus Barkley. Throw Mark Engram in the mix. It's a whitewash in favor of Barkley all day. He definitely outran what the Saints put out there for a running game. You see what he did, getting 72 yards in the passing game as well. Just a great all-around performance and three touchdowns for Saquon Barkley. Yep, probably leading the way for Rookie of the Year at this point. And we're going to go ahead and level him up in elusive back. And plus ones across the board there for that package upgrade. What do we got coming up next week? Well, we're going to look at that in a second. It's going to be the 2-1 Carolina Panthers. We're going to have to tangle with Cam Newton, and it's going to be a road test for us. You see where Barkley stacks up here with the running backs in the league. 477 yards rushing already in four games, obviously averaging over 100 a game and 5.5 average per carry with five touchdowns. And he definitely performed well enough to be the NFC Offensive Player of the Week. So when we come back, it's going to be Saquon Barkley taking on Cam Newton, and the Carolina Panthers. Do come back for more Madden 19 Career Mode with our rookie Saquon Barkley. We'll see you next time.